want to talk to you about Jonathan, who, and his big complaint is, Doc, I'm 34 years old. I'm not even 35 yet. And all of a sudden, in the past 6 months, I have ED, and I'm calling to see if you can tell me what I can do to get things back on track. Now, I want to use Jonathan as the example of the conversation we're having today because you may be experiencing something similar. These types of conversations with younger people were really kind of few and far between. We would always go back to performance anxiety, right? So I think in any case, after it becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy, you go, you get in there, you try it, you're like, I didn't perform like I wanted to. What happens? There's going to be some level of performance anxiety, but let's get to the very crux of the main reason why Jonathan is struggling with erectile function right now. I'm going to give you a hint as to what this thing is that Jonathan's doing, and you're likely doing it too, that is interfering with not just your erectile function, but when you decide to go to have kids, it's likely interfering with your fertility as well. So one thing I want you to keep in mind is that when we're talking about erectile function, we've got a variety of different components that we have to take in mind, right? Of course, there's the mental piece that comes from performance anxiety, anxiety in general, or even you just assuming it's not going to work, so it won't, right? The brain also being, am I attracted to this person or not? The other piece you got to think about is blood flow. Are our blood vessels intact? Do they have some type of dysfunction so that they're not producing nitric oxide the way that you want them to? And or is there some other reason why blood flow isn't getting to where it needs to go? Then, of course, there's nerve function. Like, what are the nerves doing around the erection? Are they firing and triggering off like they should be? And then, of course, there's the hormonal piece. How are my hormone levels, particularly when we're talking about gentlemen and we're talking about sex in general, whether it's a male or a female? We're talking about testosterone. So keeping those key things in mind, we're always addressing erectile function from one of those different ways. And we're addressing erectile power in one of those four ways too. So I want you to think about it like this. So I want you to take a look at this gent, right? So he's using his cell phone, but I want you to take a look at what he's doing that you may be doing too, that is going to interfere with his erectile function if it hasn't already, and is also potentially going to interfere with some of the things that you've got going on too. So I want to talk a little bit about your cell phone and your Wi-Fi. So Wi-Fi and all generations of mobile devices are classified as a type of radiation called non-ionizing radiation, and they fall within the microwave range of anywhere from like 3 to 300 gigahertz. So when we're looking specifically at mobile phones, you know, the 3G versus the 4G versus the 5G, back when everything was just 3G, that was just about 2,500 megahertz of energy being coming from that device. Now, when we're talking about 4G and 5G, which is basically like fourth generation and fifth generation, because think about it, we're going up in the generation, so we want to go up in speed. So in order to go up in speed, we got to go up in radiation to get that way, right? So now we're dealing with frequency ranges between 2 gigahertz and 300 gigahertz, right? So this is a huge jump. And there have been plenty of studies that have tried to look at whether or not this EMF radiation or this electromagnetic field radiation or radio frequency radiation and how it's impacting the human body. And what they're doing when they're looking at it in terms of using a standardized unit known as specific absorption rate. So think of that as SAR. And SAR measures how much energy from radio frequency waves are actually absorbed by our tissues. And then it's calculated out as watts per kilogram, right? So that's just a fancy way of saying that for years now, they have really been studying how much of this radio frequent waves are actually absorbed by our tissue. And if, and how much damage will it do if done so? And as a matter of fact, mobile phones are classified by the World Health Organization as a possible carcinogen, meaning it possibly causes cancer. Now, there's so much money in these devices that you'd be hard-pressed to find any study that just absolutely says, yes, it's going to damage it. It's going to damage the body. It's going to damage sperm. It's going to damage everything. But what I want to do is look at what the data is telling us and look at what we know. And clinically, what I've seen when it comes to erectile dysfunction and keeping those phones as close to you as possible. So according to here in the United States, the Federal Communications Commission, right? They're saying that the limit of SAR should not exceed 1.6 watts per kilogram, right? As averaged over a gram of tissue. So basically, they're saying that anything above that could potentially bother the tissue, but maybe not. So the legal limit for RF radiation is 3.8 watts per kilogram versus that 1.6 that everyone is saying should be the limit. So cell phones have been labeled possible carcinogens, but when they did a study and they took 141 cell phones, right? This is when the iPhone got in trouble. They found that when the iPhone 12 was held in the hand or carried in the pocket, its level of electromagnetic energy absorption was like 5.74 watts per kilogram. And so basically, that was a little higher than the law allows. So it became this big thing, you know, is the iPhone 12 terrible for you? In the European Union, they banned the sales of it. But let's talk about how something as simple as that is going to impact erectile function. So when we're talking about the electromagnetic fields and the radiation, what we're talking about is thermal effects, and we're talking about non-thermal effects. And so when we're thinking about thermal effects, we're talking about the heat that's actually created by taking this phone and holding it close to our bodies, right? So it became very clear, listen, we're not supposed to hold them up here. So let's everybody start using headphones. So we started using headphones because the whole idea is keep this thing that's emitting thermal radiation, thermal effects away from our head because it could potentially cause a brain tumor or some other type of disruption, right? So keep it as far away from the body as possible. The other type of radiation is non-thermal radiation, which is associated with kind of the formation of what we talk about all the time, which are reactive oxygen species, and which then causes oxidative stress. Oxidative stress is what ages blood vessels and ages our skin and ages the erection before it should age. Right. So when you're thinking about it, when you think about reactive oxygen species and we think about oxidative stress, you always want to think about it. The counterpart of that is how do we counteract the effects of oxidative stress and reactive oxygen species? Since we know we got to be around it. Right. Listen, you got to use your cell phone. You got to use your computers. You got to use all this technology. But how do you protect particularly your erection from this type of thing? So when we're talking about it, we know for a fact. Now, this has been studied in Wistar rats. It's been studied across the board. We know for a fact that hormones, particularly the testicles and the Leydig cells, are very sensitive to this form of radiation. The radiation that's coming from our mobile phones, the radiation that's coming from our Wi-Fi devices. And if you can imagine, you got your cell phone attached to your Wi-Fi device in your house. So it's coming from your Wi-Fi device and it's coming from your phone. And particularly your Wi-Fi might be sitting right next to you, your router's right there, your cell phone's in your pocket. We see that with this level of radiation, there is going to be a reduction in the cells that make testosterone in the testicles. And not just a reduction in the cells, but also a reduction in the production of viable sperm, right? So sperm that's healthy and happy and vibrant and moving like it should. And we see this particularly in rodents because there haven't been enough studies in this particular area when it comes to human beings. So we know that mobile phones and the Wi-Fi cause increased oxidative stress and apoptosis, which is, remember, apoptosis is a process of programmed cell death that you want to happen, right? You want some cells to die on a programmed basis, but you don't want the cells to die prematurely. And what we see in particular in animal models is that when they are exposed to this radiation coming from the mobile phones, coming from the Wi-Fi, you have programmed cell death of the cells that are supposed to make testosterone. And that ultimately becomes one of the main disruptions that you can potentially see by keeping this cell phone so close to your body like that, right? How many gentlemen do you know walk around with it stored either in the front of their pocket or in the back of their pocket, right? So this has to change. If you want to improve erectile function, one of the first things that I say is let's look at your Wi-Fi, let's look at your phone, and make sure that you're keeping it out of your pocket. You got to find some other way. This is why men are starting to wear the man purses, so they can actually transport their devices in some other way other than sticking it in their pocket. Now, so we've seen changes in sperm quality based off of this. We've seen changes in testosterone levels. But I also want to share with you a very clear study which looks at, that looks at sperm, not erectile function and EMF radiation. So cell phone usage and erectile function. So this is a study where they took 20, you know, men. So this is a small study, and they were all complaining of erectile dysfunction for at least 6 months. And then they compared the 20 guys to 10 healthy guys with no complaints of ED. And they studied them, and they gave them questionnaires, and they looked at the index of erectile dysfunction. And what they did is they published results that basically found that it's actually dependent on the amount of time that these gentlemen had their phone on their body, whether or not it impacted on their ability to get and maintain an erection. So with this, it becomes very clear that if you have to carry your phone in your pocket, if this has to be something that you have to do, that what you want to do is make it quick, get it in the pocket and get it out. But for those of you who are really at this point of trying to figure out, listen, I'm in my 30s, things aren't going as great as I would like them to. What does this mean for me in my 60s? The first thing that you have to do is stop carrying that cell phone around in your front pocket, because carrying it around in your front pocket will expose you to excessive levels of electromagnetic radiation, which can impair erectile function, and it's doing it through thermal ways, and it's also doing it through non-thermal ways. And when it comes to the oxidative stress that you're encountering on a daily basis by putting it either on your lap or actually putting it in your pocket, one of the best things that you can do is increase the antioxidants in your diet, integrate the smoothie recipes into your regimen so that you know on any given day your antioxidant levels are taken care of so that they can fight off these free radicals and this reactive oxygen species. The next thing you want to do is make sure that whenever you're using your cell phone, you are using earphones or putting it on speakerphone. And when I suggest earphones, I'm not suggesting the cool wireless kind. I'm actually suggesting the kind that you wire into the device, because that cuts down on the amount of radiation that you're exposing your head to. Because when you put those things in your ears, guess what? That's more radiation that your body is exposed to. So of course, there's more studies that need to be done. There's more data that we need to have on the studies of electromagnetic fields and electromagnetic radiation on the body. But it is clear that it is impacting erectile dysfunction, and it's impacting testosterone levels. So get those phones out of your pockets, and I will see you next week. Like this video, share this video, and don't forget, you know, we got a free smoothie recipe up there. Get your eFunction smoothie recipes and use them. All right.